train. You say, when me check it out, you know. If you have 10 country, you have 10 guys who run the 10 country.
Yes.
As far as me is concerned, up till now, me don't see a righteous leader in the earth except His Imperial Majesty. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Now me can't talk for Africa because Africa is Africa. Africa is
Africa. Would you like to live in Africa?
I have to live in Africa. Yes. Africa have to be a woman. Mm-hmm.
So one day, one good day, you might say, you would be returning to live in some part of Africa.
Yeah.
You will have a home one day in Africa, even if you still have to travel.
I have a home in one day in Africa. I have a home in Africa.
Well put. I stand corrected.
Yeah.
Yes. Now, what do you think of Muhammad Ali?
Greatest boxer ever.
Have you met him? Have you had pleasure meeting him?
I see him face to face, but never really meet him with shaking hands.
Yes.
Was it him?
Yeah.
My boxer.
See.
Muhammad Ali is an example to the earth. Mm-hmm. You know, he's one of the greatest men ever come out.
Uh-huh.
You know. And defend, and appreciate them a lot.
Yes, yes. Do you think his religious beliefs has given him further strength and so forth?
Yeah, him having faith, you know.
It's like you, your faith gives him strength.
Him having faith in a way of him doing and him believing in a God. You know what I mean? Even the name of me call my God is not that in the film God has.
But
as long as, to the long run, as long as I'm a deal with God, uh-huh. and deal with a righteous God, mm-hmm. then the whole of me are going to go in the same direction in the long run. Mm-hmm. Because, you know.
Now, a lot of your fans have been phoning us up and saying they never knew that you were coming to Britain or you had shows planned because no publicity was put out.
It was a quick thing, you know, because we just finished
but
the tour.
But you still pulled a big crowd. But even it was nice still for the promoters still to put out some publicity, just to say that you
I
were
think
able
the promoters never really knew if we were going to come or not, because it was a last minute agreement. And
oh yeah. Okay. So in what was the spacing of time between the show's actual date of the show and the planning?
We finished the show in where the place name again, in LA, like, at about 2 day rest. 2 days between. We rest 1 day and we take the plane the next day and come here.
Mm-hmm. It was a hell of a grapevine then.
Yeah, just a
very good grapevine, yeah. A lot of people waiting on
straight
waiting to see them. Oh yes, tell us about your last visit here. We gathered you had some problems like a beast club and this sort of thing. Tell us what really went
like
wrong.
What?
You had some problems. One of the places where a club in Peckham, I think its name is Bees. Mr. Bees. Yeah.
When we went down, we were
really
on Mr. Bees, and when we went down there, they had some advertisement in the place.
Yeah.
Well, this little guy from Jamaica now, from Clarendon in Jamaica. Mm-hmm. This guy go around and tear down all of the advertisement them. You know what I mean?
What was that? What the advertisement was about? Was it concerning you?
Yeah, it's them just like decorated the place
uh-huh.
with the wheelers. And
did the guy concern your group?
No, this no. guy, him work for the people who own
the club.
The club.
Yeah.
Him going and tear them off.
Yeah.
So, we asked him when
that, to tear them off. Yeah, I think that was disrespectful.
We asked him when to tear them off. So, him started talking to some law, you know. So, I said, alright.
Did he have anything to do with the club?
I think one of the guys, them was a deal with him. It was a girl for one of them guys, it looks like.
So they straightened him out?
Yeah.
And so what, did you all play tonight?
No, we don't want to play.
There were all the repercussions and...
Yeah, they mashed on the vibration, man. Can't play in them type of vibrations.
True.
We need them vibration of playing.
Isn't everything artist's appearance? Because it's a dancing in any club, you always got something to
play. You can play at the night, you can play. And the place decorated. No, you're going to play tonight.
The
people come to the place, them come to see you play.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now people going on Mr. B when we don't play.
Mm-hmm.
But the people who them advertised to is them people that come to see we tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Now we sorry to the people and couldn't get to see the show, but we know that the people understand the situation, knowing that the guy wrong to try deal with the and them just like a disrespectful way there and you know. And then, you know, never worth it because
okay. Oh, well, we're going to bring it to a close because I gather you got to go out or something like that. Maybe? So are you going to be doing any recordings before you leave Britain?
No.
No, I see. So we won't be seeing anything on television soon? No, nothing's been done? Aside from what's been done in the...
No, we don't do anything over here.
I see. Yes, there's one question it slipped me. A lot of us have taken great note that you are the first artist out of Jamaica to command such a massive English crowd, you know?
Yeah.
You got any ideas on that? Anything you want to say on that? The English
audience? Just say again, like, the youth are today ready.
Mm-hmm.
You're true.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and the English ready.
Yes.
And it's just up and that.
Did it please you? Does it normally please you to see that such massive mixed audiences and so forth, rather than predominantly black or predominantly white audiences? You know.
Really dig what's happening, you know.
Mm-hmm.
No, I have no like, no dislike. I just know several them people.
Who have you got to take it for?
I'm off to be there.
Right. Oh. Okay. Any more questions? Good. Can't think of anything.
But sure it's wild though, you know?
What do you think of your Prime Minister?
Great.
You've met him?
Yeah, chat.
Yeah.
He is the best Prime Minister I ever come in a job. You know?
Yeah?
I'm not a politician, but you can't see when someone try a thing.
Yes.
And if I got a try a thing, you have to say yes, my try.
Oh yes, let's ask you about it. Have you worked in the other parts of the West Indies, been to the islands and so forth?
No.
Would you like to tour the West Indies?
Yeah, I'd like to tour the West Indies.
I see. Who's arranging that?
Dante, you're supposed to get.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So about trying to get an 8 record that's number one?
In West Indies? Oh,
no, in the country. So I've been into the...
Well, if we release that single...
The thing about each record is, you know, you must realize, say, in a place like even England, you can't get... If you really look for each record, you can't get hurt.
Mm-hmm.
You don't look for each record.
See, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Play music.
If it happens, it happens.
Mm. Yeah, play music. Mm. Look for each record, you know, it come like, God said, thou shalt not want. And then you gotta go you want at each record, you never get that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, I want each record and then we'll put it. We want to just gradually grow till consciousness reach.
What's one minute? You got one relaxing.
Yeah, I got
No, relaxing now, you got one
relaxing. Yeah, I got one in the first day, yeah.
Okay, good.
You know?
Oh yes, tell me about the rest of the group. Family man, give the full names of the whole group.
Aston Barrett,
what is
family man, played bass.
Bass man.
Carlton Barrett played the drums. Al Anderson played lead guitar.
Al Anderson, yeah.
Tyrone Downey played the keyboard. Yeah.
Right. Or
Alfonso Seeker played cambos and percussion, you know.
Yes.
And you play the rhythm guitar.
How long has the group been together now?
Well,
how many years?
We've been together for quite a while. What tell you the years, like the amount of years?
Over 5 years.
Some members new.
Yeah.
Some members.
But how old is the name? You know.
Wheelers.
Yes.
Well, the Wheelers are about 12 years old.
5 years old, right?
Yeah,
right. But how many LPs have you all done? How many singles?
Well, we do about, tell you about singles, we can't tell you how amount of singles we do, but well, we suppose we do about 3, 4, 5 LPs, but them about more than that, pirates, to choose and pirates, you know.
Yeah. Hear that, huh?
Yeah, well, they're not just go down.
Rip off all the artists them, mm-hmm. one.
Yeah. Well, go down and do management.
Please, no guy can rob me. Me is the type of man.
About how much you say you're worth now?
Me?
Yes.
I'm worth more than worth.
Nice.
No, we heard a rumor a few months back that the, was it Island or some oil record company was paying you £120,000 for some something or paying some company.
£120,000
For
what?
For your contract or something. I'm not sure the information.
Yeah, we get a couple good offers, you know.
Uh-huh.
But we don't really rush something with this one, like.
Could you give us any idea the figure of the offers?
We'll get
a million, 2 million, half a million.
I think we get one at a time, Motown must have half, go $500,000 one at a time, you know,
how long ago was that?
One time Marvin Gaye was in Jamaica.
Oh, that's it, a couple of years now.
Yeah, it's a year. They never really come to me, come say that. There's mm-hmm. a guy come to me who he managed Marvin Gaye, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And in the one, like, feel it out mm-hmm. with the company. But we couldn't do it because still like on a little thing with Blackwell and
yeah,
you know.
Yes. So you say someone really, really have to offend you for you to cut with them. What is the worst thing a human being can do to you?
There's nothing worse a human being can do to me. You know? Because we can't understand what human being try. No, we talk about human being. You have people who's not human being, you know.
I
have two high and foot.
It's
and
human being, yeah. It's what's in here.
Different things. Ants have life. Flies have life. See a guy walk out there, you don't know if it's a pig life, my body, hands life, or wish life.
What is your views on marriage? You know, what's your views on marriage?
Marriage, I don't believe in a marriage that much. You know?
Are you married?
Never.
Yeah. But we heard of the eye tree.
Rita Marley.
Yes.
Well, Rita Marley is Rita Marley. She sing with the name Rita Marley.
I see. She's not your common-law wife or wife by
deal. She's a woman of babies with me too, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Does she have your name legally by law?
No.
Not that's a true marriage.
No, it's just a thing. You know?
How many children do you have?
To date?
Yeah.
About eight.
Eight. All with Rita?
No.
How many Rita has for you?
It's about three.
Three. How old are they? Boys.
I'm seven. Girl. 7 or 3 and 2, you know.
Yes. What are their names?
Ziggy, Stevie, and Sidella.
Ziggy,
Stevie, and Sidella.
How is Ziggy spelled?
Z-I-G-G-Y.
Z-I-W-G-Y. And the last one?
Sidella.
Spell that.
C-E-D-E-L-L-A.
C-E-L-L-A, right.
Excuse me.
Right, go. Right. I think you got most
of that. Doctor.
Go. All right.
Hey, you think you wrap it up now?
Yes, okay, I'll wrap it up now. Let's take 1 minute. So, you don't believe in marriage?
No, I believe man is supposed to... No, instead of marriage is no, marriage is... When you don't believe in marriage, I think marriage used to control a man. Marriage is a trap to control a man.
You think women are the only people that get the benefit of it? Man doesn't get the male doesn't get any benefit out of it?
No, what I want to say about marriage is that marriage is used to control a man.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It's a woman coward, you know, a man strong. Now when you're married, most time when you're going to do something, you have to tell your wife. Now your wife gonna tell you in a closed room and closed doors, say, baby, don't do that because, you know, that's not right and you shouldn't do that.
Do you think...
No, I'm gonna believe in that thing then.
Do you think if a man wants to get married, that he should wait until when he has achieved something in life, you know, he should not take the risk of getting married before he's really established?
I don't know. Marriage is too much of a responsibility when you come
to get married.
Like
that's if they want to get married.
Because you have to get ready to get married. I mean, life is not like that. You can't go
to what is your opinion of these women that, what do you call it? That's what sexual equality is, that's something.
Or woman's liberation.
Woman's lib, that's something. You know about that, woman's lib.
But woman have rights, you know. Woman have rights. Do you think I feel why woman burn out for woman liberation is because them can't get no man.
Yes.
No, all the man been men.
Yeah. What is your opinion of what you call it? The this permissive society.
What is that one?
Or sexual freedom, that sort of thing. Yeah.
I don't believe in a sodomy. Sodomy is out.
Mm-hmm.
Them talk about them things.
No, but permissive, you know, we weren't talking necessarily about queers and things. We're talking about young girls being free enough to get contraceptives and so forth.
I don't believe in birth control and all of them things.
You think there are things?
Because God said we shall be more than, we shall be like sands and seashore.
Right.
Well, because God said that Babylon try stop what God said. Because it's the whole thing, you know, it's devil is against righteousness, you know.
Right.
Me feel like if a girl feel like she don't want to get pregnant, don't do it. No, you come from the earth. No, sometimes women make mistake.
Mm-hmm.
Is them have babies and them lose them shape.
Yes.
And some annex girl look on that and she don't really dig it. But you have to exercise.
Yes.
Where if a woman have a youth, she can cool and get herself back together and grow a youth a little while. But come like the food that people eat is pure sex maniac food, as you eat the food you want, like sexual intercourse.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So you find them get trapped. Let me say, man, I'm trying to have control, don't we have plenty of man? You know what I mean?
Okay. All right, this is heavy, right?
Thank you very much. I'll be here, man. We like talk about you, man. Yes, I love talk about
you. So, the idea the world having all different races so you can select as you please. If you want to go to bed with a black man,
right,
night, all right.
Variety is the spice of life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You don't really like a random flesh.
Uh-huh.
You know, who will be my woman? Because the time, you
do you have any particular choice of age race? Do you have any prejudice against when she's over 30, over 40? Or if a woman
yeah,
just...
Yeah, I mean, you're supposed to deal with the young people.
Right. If a woman is married, does it necessarily stop you?
If a woman have a man,
yeah.
She don't deal with me.
Yeah, but if you...
Don't, if you have a man...
If you have an affair with a woman, right, and you discover after that you're married, do you have any...
No, me can't have no affair with a woman.
You dismiss her straight away?
After that. No, me chat to her so much that she have to tell me everything. You know what I mean? It's needless she got to hide something from me. Because
yeah.
We don't mean her no harm.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. She can just mm-hmm. tell me.
So you try to,
you know what I mean?
all of the fears you have, when a girl leaves your bed, you leave her with something. You like to know that you give her something to go through life with, mentally.
Yeah, no, I like dealing with a girl. No, the type of girl who me love dealing with is a girl who defends something.
Yes.
Like me, I go look for a girl, like, what's your name?
This is the...
Who she is.
her name there.
I love that boy.
She defend anything. When you have a girl look like she, what's her name? She in America.
Yeah, and Angela Davis.
Angela Davis. Don't make her look for a girl like Angela Davis. And
you done some fantastic
she a woman right away.
Yeah.
Woman like that who defend something. We appreciate
yeah.
woman who
yeah.
have head.
You're an Aquarian, true Aquarian.
Yeah,
yeah.
I like people who don't deal with nothing.
True. Alright. Alright, what more can we tell us?
Cool still, you know?
You might hear everything we want to hear.
Okay then, Bob. So we'll be seeing you soon again in Britain.
Yeah,
nice. Are you eager to do another major tour very soon?
Well, physically, you know, if I get enough rest and everybody feel physically can do it.
Did you wish if it was a longer tour?
No.
You don't like long tour?
No, can I tour in England longer? It was a tour in America.
Do you mind working during the winter?
America.
Or, I don't know, before the summer?
Yeah, we like work anytime, but we especially like work in the winter. Or sometime You see, we just come from Jamaica and come to England, right? Yeah. Everybody gets sick.
Oh, yes.
It's cool.
Oh, yes. See, it's even during summer, yes.
So you can imagine during winter.
See. Okay, then, Bob. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
No woman, don't cry.
Molly, Monday afternoon. Bob, we'd like you to tell us, for the benefit of the readers of the West Indian world, a bit about yourself, how you first started, how you discovered you had a talent to entertain, and what conviction led you to become the image that you have created of yourself in the eyes of the people, and what driving force you believe. Is it a conviction, a dedication, or what? Because your music is out of the ordinary. It seems to have a message.
This is the third, fourth, and fifth generation when we are the children that seek God and become reggae music deal with natural reality. And so that's where we get the force from. Where we get the force from, you know? From Rastafari, who's the leader of the earth. For no special people, for all people.
Sorry. Yes, okay, we'll leave that part for the moment, and let's discuss your present tour of Britain. I believe it was just 4 dates.
Yeah.
The Lyceum in Strand, two nights, Birmingham. Where was it in Birmingham you played? Was it the Top Rank or?
The Globe or the Odeon, something like that.
The Odeon, was it? Was it a cinema?
I think it was a cinema
place.
The Odeon in Birmingham and the Hard Rock Manchester.
Yeah.
Let's skip London for the time being. How would you say the audience, how do you compare the audience in London to Birmingham?
I can't compare like audience, you know, because, you know.
Okay, let me put it this way.
Well, I can explain something to you. The audience, wherever the audience is always great.
Mm-hmm.
Now, sometimes you can go up on stage and you go through little things like electrical technicalities, you know what I mean, where something I'd take from your mood. But what I know about audience, as I am an audience still inside a crowd at times, is that if the music up on the stage good and the people have played it and them are right and them are playing it and them in time and them playing it and them doing it right, then the audience most of them say yes.
Mm-hmm.
No, you can really reach for some type of lyrics where the audience don't have to say yes, but them hear. And that is sometimes.
You find
that we don't want the audience clap.
Uh-huh.
That when we sing a tune like Slave Driver and them tune there, the audience listen. It's not entertainment. It's truth. It's like, you know, it's truth.
Yes, yes. Or then you say your audience say they admire you so much that should there be any technical faults on stage, They gladly cooperate and they have all the patience in the world.
Great, you know, them people are them just ready. The most true. But it's not the music and it's not me.
Yeah. So you would say it's the cooperation music, that they gave you the courage.
It is the third and the fourth generation and we are the children that seek reality.
Right.
And that is why, like, the people can say, yeah, because they're really wrong. But you see, things force on from people, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Advertisement, force on.
You can smoke if you want to smoke, you know, don't mind that.
Yeah, you know, advertisement, force on things and people.
Yeah, yes.
And so people get education and them live to the things that with them been taught to them.
How do you compare the back home crowds to the reception here of Jamaicans in Britain, West Indians in Britain here?
Well, I tell you the truth, you know. Everything been nice.
Mm-hmm.
Everything all right, you know.
Yeah.
The people appreciate. Now in Jamaica, they appreciate new step for tech, like play the music oneself.
Right.
And the people appreciate
original stuff, and creative, and so
on. Like we playing instruments, now, you know.
Mm-hmm.
First, we only used to sing. Do you go to changes that I do? Because
yes, because you had some problems.
But it's not really a problem, it's just that you know, sometimes touring get hard.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not all about people want to do it, especially if they don't have to do it.
Yes.
That is what might be like the problem. Well, as far as me is concerned, the precarious problem, we can't really stay in a Jamaica and think the Jamaicans alone
Jamaica. No.
So
you got to spread the gospel.
That is how it kind of come over, you know.
Do you ever feel that you have a vocation?
A what?
A vocation, a purpose.
Well, I feel a man supposed to have one special purpose.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, man have talent, you know.
Where did the name the Wheelers?
From the Bible.
You took it from the Bible?
Yeah.
What part of the Bible?
Some place in the Bible. It's plenty place in the Bible you meet up from weeping and wailing. Children are
weeping and wailing,
you know.
Yes,
crying out for justice and all that.
Yes. Is your real name Bob Marley?
Bob Marley. Well, the name...
Oh, that's
no,
statement.
That name is not my name.
Uh-huh.
But birthright wise, like birth certificate and everything there.
Uh-huh.
Let them really have on it.
Can you tell us something about your parents? You got some brothers and sisters? And
yeah, they have some brothers and sisters, very young.
Yeah. Could you give us their ages?
Well, I don't really know their ages.
Yes. How many brothers do you have?
I have about two brothers.
And sisters?
Two sisters.
And you're the eldest?
Well, yeah, I'm the eldest one for my people, like my mother, you know. Because my father is a different type of guy. We have some other children.
Yes. Both parents alive?
No, father dead.
Your father is deceased?
No, my father was a guy from England here.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yes.
He was like you can read it, you know. It's one of them slave, it's one of the slave stories.
Yes.
White guy get the woman and breed her and come, you know.
Oh. What's your father's race? Is he a black man? Is he a mixed race or what?
He was an English guy.
An Englishman?
I think.
Yeah.
Come see him one time, you know.
And your mother's Negro? Is black?
Mother African.
Right. Do you have any other relatives that are in the musical business? In the musical field? And your brothers or sisters? Are they taken after?
Well, they're young, but them.
They're interested.
They love music. I see.
Any other relatives you want to talk about?
Well, I have plenty of brethren, and I'm not really dealing with relatives that way. I'm dealing with real secrets of people.
Do you see yourself being able to change the course of events in Jamaica through your music, influencing the... You...
That is not our purpose again.
No.
Our purpose is to win the brain of black people, better realize.
But don't you think lending some cultural, real cultural purpose,
awakening
to the people of
awakening
people.
Things where people have lodged up in their head back. Where if somebody don't go there and wake it up, they don't realize it because there's so much advertisement to go around here, you know. There's so much thing confused that means. Somebody directly have a come.
Would you say that is people outside of Jamaica that has done more for your music?
Than Jamaica?
Yes.
No, I wouldn't say that.
No, from the field of finance and promoting and so forth.
Well, we can't say for the years, but we still get ripped off and get the right deal still. Because, you know what I mean? You know, people think more black people come from Jamaica.
Are you signed to anybody now? Of course, there's been a lot of rumors that Bob isn't signed here. If you belong to
anything. We kind of have obligation before Chris Blackwell and Highland Records, but right now, we're up on renegotiation. We'll chat over the business guys.
Yeah, because we gather that you're a very shrewd businessman, as well as a musician. You have a very good head for business.
No, I'm not really have a good head for business. Any guy can rob me.
No,
but we know same rob me. You know
what
I mean?
Because
we rob me and
we keep hearing stories that you with Trojan, you with Island, you with this. We don't know, you know.
There's a place where them guys, all them just rob me, like children now. Them take my stuff from me and bring me stuff.
Without your permission?
Like, without my permission. Now them have about three albums out there. Without my permission. And to know how they see one of the guys that deal with the book manager and check it out, you know. But this thing,
who's
like
your manager?
Dan Taylor, you know. Dan
Taylor. Is he a Jamaican?
Yeah, he's a Jamaican.
He resides in Britain, is he?
No, he resides in America.
Mm-hmm. So he handles it. Tell us about the US market and so forth. How you get on over there. We got that here.
Well, yes, America.
And you've done some shows over there. Could you tell us about the USA? We
did some show over there. They call it Reactions.
Well, so where did you play in the United States?
Play a couple places, well, like play Chicago, Boston, Detroit, Cleveland, New York, Los Angeles, San Francisco. Most a couple more places.
Can you tell us any sort of, give us any sort of figures in the size of audiences, the largest audience you've played to?
Largest audience? Large audience must be 4,000 or 5,000.
4,000 or 5,000. Do you play in New York?
No, 13,000 a year, I think.
Because I was hearing something like 40,000, that's all the same.
Yeah, a couple thousand. I don't know you know.
Are you a poor crowd estimator?
Eh?
You don't take any interest in actual how many, you don't take steps to find out how many people were at a given concert or so.
Most
of
the
did you play at Madison Square Garden?
All the places that they book out, no. All the places that they book out, all of them was like, you got it.
Human
life. All of them was full.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Place them. Sell out.
Yeah.
You know? Some place don't hold plenty of people. 400.
Which company is releasing for you in the States?
Well, it's still Blackwell have a company over there, you know.
I see.
And knowing that at the time, like this time, you know, it's like, it might be. I do a good job. Can do a good job if my manager. You show them, say them have to do a good job.
So this tour that you've recently completed here in Brisbane, right? Who actually promoted it?
The tour?
Yeah.
Well, the tour really come from Tuff Gong, you know. We decided
from
on the tour. Tuff Gong is our record.
Spell that name.
T-U-F-F-G-O-N-G.
Right. And it's a company of yours. So
yeah.
It's your personal company that handles the tour.
Yeah.
Right.
But ABC Bookings was the one who sponsored it too, like, not sponsored, I get the booking companies together.
I see. Oh, so, when would you be leaving England?
Thursday.
And where you go to?
I'm going to New York and go back to Jamaica.
I see. But how soon will you be coming back to England?
I don't really know yet.
So, I gathered that, within the next few months, something is going to be happening for you, or so?
Me?
Yeah. I see.
Something like what?
I just said, you know, we get rumors on the grapevines and another major show, something like that.
Yeah?
Yes. I gather that this was just an exploration tour.
The final?
Yes, what the reaction
yeah,
was.
Yeah, but
like.
them can't explain, you know, them weird to people.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, you know.
So that was more like a promotional thing.
Yeah, I know.
Not that
where,
you have been exploited.
What I know is, you know about people more than plenty of people.
Right.
Knowing that he's a Aquarian.
You're Aquarian? What's
Aquarian.
Your what's your date of birth actually?
6th of February today.
Oh, I'm the 26th of Jan.
Yeah.
Right. How you go? Right. When were you born? What year?
I was born
1948. I mean, 2 years younger. I thought he was old. Right. Is there any planned television appearances or anything?
Black television, I.
Over there?
No.
In Hollywood?
No.
In Hollywood. And what is that for? When is it going to go out?
A concert.
Video tape. They're going to sell it to national networks.
What about program name? What name? What do you think? Why not transfer?
Yeah.
Their program, they could have so much.
Yeah.
So they're going to go this day.
Uh-huh. It's going to be released in this country. So, has any of your shows here been filmed? Because I saw cameras around. I know some of the.
Not right now, official.
Well, I saw some cameras standing up.
Yeah.
Yeah, right at the lights.
Might do it, yes. They might do that.
They tried doing that with John Ho, secretly, but we spotted the wire.
Yeah.
Yeah. And recorded. You know, your shows were recorded as well. You know that. Is there going to be a live album coming out? Bob Marley live at so and so.
Well,
if you got to listen to it first.
Yeah.
You got to think the fans would really like that. Yeah. Fans would really like something like that.
Yeah.
Any questions, Arrow? Like to give any special message to your fans? You know? Do you have a fan club?
You have a fan club.
In Holland, I mean for Britain. Would you like the West Indian world to handle that for you?
Yeah, you know.
You like us to raise a fan club for you?
Yeah. That's interesting. And then
I. What do you do for a few artists?
No West Indian world.
Don't mind.
Do whatever you want.
Yeah. Man.
You got.
Sit down on the can, so you got a good level. Oh, you know.
You talk, don't mind me.
Yeah, right. Are you averse to photographers? You're a bit fed up now with journalists and photographers?
All right, some journalists, all right, some photographers, all right.
What do you think is the worst mistake a journalist could make in your presence? What sort of questions?
Misinterpret. Rastafari.
Uh-huh.
That's the only mistake, because that is the main message.
Right, right.
So when a journalist misinterprets it, it's like...
Oh, yes, you take all of us, right?
A joke.
Uh-huh.
You know,
right.
You know what I mean? But what I like is when they really deal with it,
mm-hmm.
upful and truthful.
Uh-huh.
You know?
Tell us something about the doctrine of Rastafari.
Well, Rastafari means head creator.
Yes.
Right? And the head creator must be the Almighty, as long as he is the head creator.
Yes.
Good.
How does it, how do you associate that with your music? Do you think it has a very important effect on the creative
identity? It's natural.
Identity?
You know what I mean? It's natural. It's so natural as King David was a great musician.
How
King Solomon,
yes.
You know, mm-hmm. and them coming from the same lineage, El Selassie.
Mm-hmm.
What are
so
you?
So it's the music. Music is a must in the earth.
Mm-hmm.
It's only say true what really happened on the earth. Why the music be where what it is today? That you know,
yes.
Music is not like China music where you know you're in a whole heap of protests and going.
Yes,
we have a protest because. But it's the black man do God wrong things, and that's why I'm suffer so much. And I'm telling him roots that Rastafari is the Almighty, and Rastafari is earth rightful ruler. Then that is when black man will stop suffer.
How old were you when you were first introduced to the faith?
When I wasn't introduced to it, born a Rasta man.
Right, I see. You're born into it and so forth.
So, could you in that version,
creative.
You got strong Bible belief.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Could you tell us about if there's any particular restrictions on diets regarding the faith?
Yeah, we don't eat pork.
You don't eat pork? What else?
And you don't eat shrimps, lobsters, any fish without scales.
Unscaled fish?
Yeah.
Right.
And
could you perhaps enlighten the readers how the lapsin was first introduced, how old is it?
My lapsin is about maybe two years old.
Uh-huh.
I don't really know.
Uh-huh. Could you tell them how you care
for
it?
They relax. Uh-huh. I mean, you wash it, right?
Yeah.
Shampoo, you keep it as clean as you can.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
And then it grow.
Uh-huh.
And it grow.
Yeah.
It locks. You know what I mean? Sometimes.
How do you, if when it grows out here, you got to plait it again? How you do it?
No, you don't plait it. It always locks itself.
Oh, I see. I see.
You know? You don't put nothing in it.
I think that's great, you know?
Yeah.
You don't put nothing in it. Now, which part? Plenty of journalists make mistakes again. Is when them say, knitted and wax.
But this is why I'm getting to the root of it, you see.
In fact, just everything you're saying,
it's going to go out just as you say. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm not going to interfere with anything. This is going out as a... Yes. So, what do you think of a... the respect for Rastafari by Jamaicans in Jamaica, and comparing Jamaicans in New York, in America, and the Jamaicans in Britain, who to use it, which of the
respect
to have
Rastafari
more enlightenment?
Yes, mm-hmm. The Jamaican people gone ahead, you know.
The enlightened Jamaicans?
Jamaica people gone ahead.
Mm-hmm.
People who live in Jamaica, and people who live all about, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Rasta, wherever they may be,
mm-hmm.
You know, you just say.
Is there a particular meaning to Rastafari? Is that a translation?
Rasta means head, Tafari means creator.
Uh-huh, yes.
That means Rastafari means head creator. Mm-hmm. Just like you just say God means head creator.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you deal with creator, guys, plenty gods, you know, guy mm-hmm. can be God.
Now, I've always noted that your mode of dress is very revolutionary. You remind me of people like Fidel Castro and so forth.
Yeah.
You don't wear suits and ties and that sort of thing.
Yeah, you know.
I think they
updated. Really have to do
that. Mm-hmm. Right.
I don't think is like weapon.
Mm-hmm. It's just that you'd like to identify with the masses, a simple man.
They're the people who act together.
No matter how much you have. How would you get? You'll always be
together. Many people
walk together. Right.